In this video, we will add and edit tasks in Tactplan. In the following section, you will learn how to make a task list, add tasks on selected locations, add tasks on all locations, change the order of a task, duplicate tasks, draw tasks, and edit tasks. Before you start adding tasks in Tactplan, we recommend that you have prepared a task list in advance by, for instance, involving the different traits in defining the relevant tasks. When you define tasks, we advise to detail the task to contain the actual work you do on site. For instance, a task called wall framing and first side gypsum is better than a more overall activity called carpenter works. You can, by advantage, consider the dependencies and order when you make your task lists. Once you have prepared your task list, you are ready to create the tasks in Tactplan. It is possible to add tasks in all schedule views, and it's individually from schedule to schedule where it makes best sense to add them. To add a task in Takt Time, please follow these steps. Click on Add Mode. Here you choose between Add to All Locations and Add to Selected Locations. You start with your first activity, sheet piling. This should only be on foundation. Therefore, select Add to Selected Locations. Once selected, click on the locations where the task is to be performed. Once the task has been added to its locations, you can name it sheet piling. Specify its durations, for example, 4 days. Give it a color, and you can choose the color brown and give all tasks related to foundation works the color brown. The next task is excavation, which has a dependency to recent task. To add it, click on Add Task, and Add to Selected, and Add Dependencies to Recent Tasks. Write the name, excavation. Set the duration, let's say 8 days, and then choose the color brown, so we know that it's for foundation. Now you can see there is a dependency between the two tasks. You choose that the dependency must be on location level staircase. Excavation must only start when sheet piling is completed on all locations. Remember to save. Now precast concrete element mounting needs to be added. Element mounting appears on a large portion of the levels. You select Add Mode again. Keep it on Add to All Locations and choose on which location level the task must be added to. When you add it to the schedule, the task is defined on all the locations on the precision level. In element mounting, one level is made at a time. As it is shown now, one staircase is made at a time. So to change the order in which element mounting is done, you must open the side menu and go to Locations. Here you will find the locations in the order in which the task is made. To change the order, go down to Staircase 2. Click on Ground Floor for Staircase 1 and pull it up on the ground floor on Staircase 1. Just like this. This way, concrete elements for one whole floor is made across all staircases before moving on with the next level in the building. Now we will show how to copy activities with the same setting across multiple locations. The next tasks we want to create has the same location as this one, partition walls first side. In that case, you can click duplicate mode. Then you can decide where the task should be placed in relation to the one you are duplicating. You can also decide if it should have dependencies for the task you are duplicating or the same dependencies as the one you are duplicating. Once selected, click duplicate task, and there comes a task just like it. Here the name is changed to plumbing routing with a duration set to 28 days. Please select the color for this activity. Remember to save. please select Flowline. In the Flowline, add tasks with the pencil in the draw mode. You draw a line where you want your task, and you can then see it. You can now select the task and bring up the side panel. Here you can write the name on your activity. And if you click on location, you can deselect the locations where the task is not to be made. And finally, type in the duration. You can also choose a color for your activity. Please remember to save. The next tasks have the same location as this one, L routing. In that case, you can click duplicate mode. Then you can decide where the task should be placed according to the one you are duplicating. You can also decide if it should have dependencies for the task you are duplicating or the same dependency as the one you are duplicating. Once selected, click Duplicate Task, and there comes a task just like it. Here you can change the name to, let's say, Ventilation. And also please remember to change the color on this new activity. Click Save. Please select Gantt. To add a task in Gantt, click Add Task. It will show in the bottom. You can double-click on the task for the side menu to appear. Here, it's possible to change the name of the activity. We will call it Partition Wall Second Side. And also remember to change the color on this activity. The task shows at all locations. If you go to location, you can deselect the locations where the task is not to be made. And this goes all the way through all your levels and all your staircases. When you have deselected the locations, you go to General, and you can here finally type in the duration. If you hover over it, you can see start and end date and also duration. Remember to click Save. The next task have the same location as this one, partition wall second side. In that case, you can click duplicate mode. Then you can decide where the task should be placed in relation to the one you are duplicating. You can also decide if it should have dependencies for the task you duplicate or the same dependencies as the one you are duplicating. Once selected, click Duplicate Task. And there comes a task just like it. Here we change the name to Painting, Putty Clay, First Layer, Paint. The more specific you are, the better it is. Now we go down and change the duration day. It actually says 42 days and this is what we need, so we don't change it here. But then remember to change the color of the activity. We change it to blue. And then please remember to save. We choose network diagram, which is very useful if you involve your traits in the scheduling in a workshop. Then you quickly add activities here and use it to discuss and define dependencies. To add a task in the network diagram, click Add Task, and it shows alongside with the side menu. Please type in the name here. Remember, the more detailed the name is, the better it is. And then please select the color for this activity. The task shows up at all locations. You can now deselect the locations where the task is not to be made. Now you go back to General, where you can also add or change the duration. Please remember to save. In the network diagram, you can also duplicate tasks. If the next task have the same locations as this one, you can click Duplicate Mode. Then you can decide where the task should be placed in relation to the one you are duplicating. You can also decide if it should have dependencies for the tasks you duplicate or the same dependencies as the one you are duplicating. Once selected, click Duplicate Task, and there comes a task just like it. Here we change the name and also the duration. Please remember to save. We now go to Task Grid. Task Grid is a table view of your whole schedule. Here you can also add tasks. To add a task in the Task Grid, click Add Task. The task shows alongside with the side menu where you type in the name and also choose the color. The task shows at all locations, and just like the other ones, you can here now deselect the locations where the task is not to be made. Then you go back to General. And finally, here you type in the duration. Click Save. These were the different ways you can create tasks into different schedule views. Which method you want to use depend on the visual project. In this training video, you have learned how to make a task list, add tasks on selected locations, add tasks on all locations, change the order of a task, duplicate task, draw a task, and edit tasks. For more training, go to tactplan.com and become a real master of schedule planning.